Hi, welcome to automationtesting.in. In this video, we will see which IDE we will use to write our protractor scripts. So first, what is IDE? Where you write your code to manage. Means as part of your framework, you need to create so many files. You need to organize those in separate folders. All these things can be done using any one of the IDEs which are available in the market. First, we will see how many IDEs are there which is best suit to write protractor script. So I made a list of popular IDEs in this slide. So Visual Studio Code, Eclipse, WebStorm, IntelliJ IDEA, Visual Studio, Notepad++. So these are few IDEs which are very famous to write the code. So each tool, means each IDE, is not only for protractor. You can write another, what you say, automation code also. It may be Selenium, it may be something else, okay? But here I'll prefer Visual Studio Code to write our protractor scripts. Why? The reason is Visual Studio Code is very lightweight, so, and it is very fast, and it will occupy less memory in your machine. And if you are very familiar with other IDEs, like from long time, if you are using Eclipse, WebStorm, IntelliJ, Visual Studio, so all these things, if you are very familiar with all these things, you can use those things also. But coming to this, what you say, memory, those will occupy more memory, and when you try to open, it will take much time to open. Okay, that is the reason I'll prefer Visual Studio Code in this series. So later part, we will see other IDEs also, how to configure protractor in the Eclipse, IntelliJ, all these things to write our protractor scripts. But as part of this series, we'll prefer to use Visual Studio Code. And coming to the Notepad++, it is also very lightweight, but when you compare to Visual Studio Code, you'll have less options, and it will only support Windows machine. So if you go to Visual Studio Code, you can use the same thing for Windows and other operating systems also, like Windows and Linux, all these things. Okay, so that's all in this video. Before concluding this video, I have a small request that please subscribe to this YouTube channel for further updates. Thank you.